Hello everyone, this is Payam, welcome to On Design channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create a suggestion box for your inputs. And this component is going to be created from another component. So this is going to be a construction item. So first we need to create this, then out of this one, we can create the input suggestion box. So without further ado, let's go right ahead and create it. As always, I've prepared the things that I need. We need the hover state, we need the focus state, we need typing. I'm going to show you in a sec how this is going to look. We need icon, we need the icon component. Actually, this is going to be the, instant swap. And then we have the active text and suggestion text. So let's go right and create it. I'm going to hit T on my keyboard, like so. And just type the first text. For example, I'm going to search for Italian food, right? But the thing that I typed is actually ITA, and the rest is going to be suggested by that input. Basically, like Google, we want to create some input like that. Then what I'm going to do is just duplicate this one, right? And then change it to, you know, complete the phrase, basically, like so. As you can see, it kind of looks, it's one text, and we want to style it right now. First thing we're going to do is select both of them and hit Shift A to create an auto layout. Then we're going to choose colors for them. So I'm going to find some colors for these. Let's go with text and maybe subtitle, like so. Actually, maybe the body 10. Actually, that's too small. Let's go with body 20, like that. And this is going to be the subtitle 20. So they fit better. As you can see, their height is the same. They're both 24. And then let's change this to body, like that. And as you can see, we have finished our first step to create a suggestion item. Now what we can do is basically add other things to it. For example, I'm going to add the icon here. So I'm going to hit Shift I on my keyboard to find an icon. So maybe find a food or something. Or let's go with the same profile that we used in our previous designs. Like so. All right. Now let's set the, color to body as well, and reduce the size to 20, maybe. You can choose like bigger or smaller, depends on your product and guidelines. And then what I can do is basically select both of them and hit Shift A one more time, set the spacing to, I think 8 is okay, let's go with 8. Like that. And then now we can add other states and basically play around with our variants. So in order to convert this to a component, I need to select it and tap here. Alternatively, you can hit command option K, or control option alt K, I believe, like so. And now you can see that we converted it to a component. Let's edit it, its name basically. It's gonna be suggestion item. And actually let's put an input behind it so we don't mess it up. But then I'm gonna show you how we can organize the whole design system. First, we need to create it. All right, then let's go create our properties. The first thing first, we're gonna create the text property, which is gonna be the active text. Well, it's gonna be ITA for the Italian food, create property. The next text is gonna be suggestion text. And the value is gonna be Italian food, create property. And now let's connect them. So this is gonna be connected to active text. And this will be connected to suggestion text, like so. And then we need another property, which is going to be the instance swap. And let's name it icon component. And let's go with profile. Just find that profile icon. Here it is. And create property. And now create property. And now I'm going to select it and connect it to my icon component. Like so. All right, now we have connected all of our content to the related properties. And now the next thing is basically create the Boolean properties and basically the variants. The first thing first, we're gonna create the icon property, which is gonna be a Boolean. And let's go with false by default. And then I'm gonna find my icon and connect its layer to Boolean, like so. And now, as you can see, it's hidden and it's gonna be shown whenever I check that box. Actually, make that switch on when using this component. All right, the next thing is gonna be the typing. So I'm gonna add another Boolean. Color typing by default is going to be true, and then I'm going to select the typing text here, and then set this layer to typing, like so. And then the next thing is basically create the hover and focus. For these, we need to create two variants. So the first variant is going to be property name is gonna be hover. All right, for this it's gonna be false. Also, we need some spacing for the styling of it. Let's go with 20 from left and right, and maybe 12 from top and bottom, like so. Or maybe that's too much, we can go smaller, maybe 8 from top and bottom. Yeah, that works. And then we're gonna duplicate this one and set it as hover. Actually, its hover should be true. And then for its hover, we're gonna go with a subtle background, like that. Now we need to create the focused one. We just duplicate these, both of them. We create a new property, which is gonna be the variant, and it's gonna be focused. The value is going to be false by default. And let's select these two and set their value to true. All right. Now let's set some stroke. Let's go to the borders. Maybe default subtle, like so. It's going to be inside is okay. Yeah. For now, let's go with 3. Too much. 2, that's 2. I think 3 is okay. And now we have successfully created our suggestion item. And now let's go ahead and create an input suggestion box. In order to do that, I'm gonna hit Shift I and find my suggestion item, like so. Then what I'm gonna do is duplicate it here. Then select both of them and hit Shift A to create an auto layout, like that. And then I'm gonna set the clip content and set some corner radius, maybe like 8 pixels. Let's set a fill color, maybe default, like so. I need some stroke too, so let's go with, default maybe. We can even add a shadow. Maybe we can go with small one, like that. And then what we can do is basically, in order to like make this a suggestion box, I'm gonna duplicate it a couple of more times, like that, and then set one of these as This is messed up in terms of, so the hover of these should be true. The hover of these should be false, like that. All right, now I'm gonna find this second one and set the hover as true, like that. And then what you can do is basically resize this one and hit enter to select all of these and set their width to fill container, like so. So you can basically have a responsive suggestion box. All right, now let's convert it to a component from where, from here again, select it and hit this one. And let's change the name to input suggestion box, like so. And then we need a variant that's gonna be typing or not. So we're gonna define the state that all of these are like suggestions, not, you know, there's no typing going on. So let's go ahead and create a variant that's gonna be typing. And then another good thing you can do with this one is basically create a nested instance, actually nested instances, and select all of these so the items here get appeared. The properties of these get appeared on your properties on the parent component. That's really a cool feature. You don't need to like select everything, like so. And then for this one, the typing is gonna be false. We're just gonna duplicate it. And here the typing is gonna be true. And for the false one, we just select all of them and hit the typing and basically set the typing off. And maybe change the suggestion text to something like, I don't know, maybe Italian food. Like that. And basically you can change all of them one by one. And that's how you can create a suggestion box. And obviously we used variables. So if you change the mode to dark mode as from here, layers, tokens, and changes to dark mode, as you can see, it gets updated automatically. But I'm not gonna do that for now. So yeah, that's it. And yeah, that's it for this video. Let's test it out on how it works. So I'm gonna hit Shift I and find suggestion, actually input suggestion box, like so. You can see that it has a background, actually it has a box shadow. And you can easily place it anywhere in your design. You can edit the box shadow from your style because it's connected, as you can see here. And then the reason we added those nested instances is that when you like choose this and you want to edit this, you don't need to like double click everywhere in order to access these items. You just select the whole box and go and edit these. First of all, let's set it to active. The active text can be like, I don't know, anything, maybe can, and then you need to edit it for all of these four, like so, and maybe just change this to Canadian, like maybe food, something like that, I don't know. You can go creative with it and just change. I just want to show you how you can edit these. Basically, I misclicked that. But yeah, that's how you can create a suggestion box and use it. And as you can see, it's fully responsive, and you can use this in your process of designing. Thank you for watching. Leave a like. Please let me know what you think on the comment section below. And please subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.